Putting the story out there is one thing, but putting it right is what we love most on Fair Go.
Yes, but after we ran a story on a contractor who'd done a runner to Tonga with customers' money, we thought it was the last we'd hear from him.
We were right about that, but it's not quite the end of the story. Here's Garth with a great result and the guys who stepped up to deliver it.
Carrie is literally washing away the past. Someone did the dirty on him and wife Estelle over a driveway contract, but it's cleaning up well now, and the dogs are about to get a run at last.
I'm pleased Estelle went to you guys in Fair Go, and we've come up with a good result.
But this is the closest my sparkly white sneakers have been to fresh concrete, so who's done the work? And who didn't do it in the first place? Time for a quick recap. This was the state of the Clendon's place when we visited months ago. Dogs penned up, frustrations pent up at a contractor who'd vanished with most of the money.
21,000 off the, 26. I think I'm a good judge of character, but this time it failed me.
And it had been the same story for another customer who'd paid $6,000 for this.
Okay, oh, nice doorstop.
Yeah, quite a large doorstop actually.
And nice deck.
Yeah, lovely. It's a bit hard perching on the post having my cup of tea.
Ian Uhatahi, the man responsible, was long gone. We hunted high and low, south of Auckland, only traces. Then we found him streaming on Facebook from back home in Tonga. Ian Uhatahi didn't return our messages. Our search for Ian has gone as far as it can. But back in Waiuku,
how are ya?
Just as it seemed bleakest, someone stepped up.
Everybody was like, oh, has it been resolved? And I was like, no. But a week or so after that, you got a call, we got a Sam arriving here, and yeah, just so happy. Really happy that we could resolve this.
And the thing is, what's been done here, I think you boys have basically done in 4 days.
Yeah.
4.5 days, job done. You know, so that's fantastic.
Well, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel.
Semisi Tawataina, Sam, to some, had an offer for the couple.
You can pay for the materials, and then we'll do the rest.
When we do preparation and everything, and do the concrete, it's more than $5,000 to do that from our pocket.
Hey.
Roughly. But anyway.
Sam called on another helper.
We're getting nothing out of this one. Out of
costing you, eh?
Yeah. So, but we wanted to do it because of the Tongan community. Got to dig out here and get the boys to come and prep this area out and lay, and then, you know, finish it off today. So, I think we made the owner of this property happy, and when they're happy, we feel, you know, we get our satisfaction from that. So,
Sam says he knows someone who knows the contractor who ran away. He wanted to step in and fix this, not dwell on that guy or on the past.
Nothing to say. It's only...
Oh, I think your work speaks for itself, Sam. I think your work speaks for itself. I don't think you have to say much because I think you've actually done something.
We look forward.
Yeah.
For the couple, it's a relief and a considerable saving.
We had to buy the materials again, but at least I did a really good job, so really, really happy. I think if you do the calculation, I don't think it's a lot more than what the total project would have cost.
What do you think of these guys?
Oh, just sort of restoring my faith in people.
Well done, and nice lot of concrete in the front.
They've built something else here, trust.
Nice to meet you,
Peter. Enjoy your driveway.
Everybody's back on a firmer footing. And some are even jumping for joy.
I feel funny in here. It might be indigestion from the $12 grapes, or maybe my heart is full from watching that.
Isn't
great job,
lovely?
Yeah.
Sam and Peter, you are good people.
Brilliant.
Okay, as for Carmen, she had already found a solution for her deck. Here it is, looking lovely, with some very happy-looking animals. Lots of happy animals tonight. She was, however, very grateful for the offer from Sam.